Valentine, the morning, it's Billy Iowa, 647. KTLA just read a headline. Most Americans don't know the importance of sleep. And in the background, they had just people sleeping. But it looked like they just got B-roll. Like they went out with their camera crew and just crawled into somebody's bedroom and filmed them sleeping. And I assume it was like people that worked there or something like that. But it looked like the creepiest video of just filming people tossing and turning in bed. And it's a guy from KTLA just crawled in a window to get this footage for their story.
That's so funny. I mean, I would assume like a camera operator just films his wife, maybe, to get that B-roll. Like, that'd be so weird to acquire that any other way.
I know, but it just looks so creepy because you're just moving around in bed and stuff. And they get the, you know, covers pulled off. And it was your, it was real footage. It wasn't that typical mattress store where they lay on the mattress and everybody's in beautiful pajamas and there's no sheets.
Right. Yeah.
You're like, nobody sleeps like that.
In the like the nicest positions. When I'm asleep, arms are flailing, legs are spread. It's just, I'm all over that bed.
Yeah, yeah. That's how most people are. You know, that's how kids are, too. Oh, my gosh. If you had a kid crawl into your bed, they turn sideways and push you and your spouse off of the bed. It's just ridiculous.
That's what our dog does. Our dog is not a small dog, and he makes an H out of me and Allie every single night.
Our dogs will come up, and one of them, Han Solo, who's the heavier set one, unfortunately, will sleep on top of my head. You know, and I wake up, and I'll wake up in the morning and go, why's my neck hurt? Oh, why is there a dog on my head? You know? It's the worst. All right, $11,500 coming up 7:25 this morning. We have the Battle of the Sexes on the way. If you're listening for the first time, good morning. My name is Valentine. I've been married for 23 years. My wife had her birthday yesterday. It was a great night. We had a lot of fun. Got a little candle that you turn the base of it and does happy birthday. You know, it's like a teeny little candle. It costs like $4. It's the worst MIDI-sounding happy birthday I ever heard. It's like, she loved it. It was very cute. And this is my friend Jill.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Jill, currently living alone during this pandemic, and found out this morning, you all found out, I perform for my cats.
As you should.
This is Kevin.
Hi, I'm Kevin, broadcasting from home like Jill right now, and currently there's a 2-year-old behind me playing a game on an iPad, so if you hear an outburst, it's not me, it's him.
Is it your 2-year-old?
Let me check.
Here's what's coming up
in Hollywood headlines.
The Academy recently told Oscar nominees that they have to attend the Oscars in person, but now they're backing off that rule. I'll tell you the latest right after traffic. This traffic report is sponsored by Taco Bell, a Sigler in downtown, 110 freeway northbound side. As you're coming up on Olympic, 3 right lanes remain blocked off. They're investigating a fatal crash. Traffic's heading now coming away from Manchester. Now, part of this, they have the 10 east and west connectors to the 110 north also shut down. 10 westbound is pretty tough as you come away from the 5. You'll see heavy delays to La Brea. Eastbound side of the 10 doesn't look bad for your drive as you're heading into downtown. And southbound side of the 110, just seeing minor delays, Stadium Way over towards Olympic. 710 freeway northbound side starting to load up at Florence. You're going to see brake lights to the 5, and then it slows again between the 60 and the 10 as you head into Alhambra. And in Glendora, 210 freeway westbound side at Sunflower. An accident here, a couple of big rigs and 2 other cars that are involved. They're saying all lanes are stopped at the moment, so you're pretty much at a standstill. You're coming away from the 57. The quesalupa from Taco Bell is back with its cheese-stuffed shell, but Taco Bell doesn't want to fall into the trap of overhyping it. Instead, they'll just give it to you straight. Taco Bell's quesalupa is back, and they think you'll like it. Available for a limited time at participating Taco Bell locations near you. That's your traffic. I'm Tony Jordan with Valentine in the Morning on 104.3 My FM.
Hollywood headlines.
A couple weeks ago, the Academy released some of the rules that they had for the upcoming Oscars, and they told Oscar nominees that they won't be able to Zoom into the show. If you want to be a part of it, you have to attend in person. They were talking about all the safety precautions they were going to take, but people were upset and said they weren't quite comfortable traveling yet or being at functions with a big group of people. So now the Hollywood Reporter is saying that all nominees are invited to a meeting with producers over Zoom today. And they're going to be given updates about the show, and apparently it includes the option to participate in the Oscars remotely. So we'll see what changes are going to be made to the rules for the Oscars. And Lady Gaga's dog walker, Ryan Fisher, he is going home after a month in the hospital after being shot in that horrible dog napping that took place earlier this year. He was apparently in the ICU. He was doing really well, and you know, even doctors and nurses were surprised at how much energy he had and how good he was feeling. And he detailed all of this on his Instagram, but he said that he was recovering, but then a part of his lung collapsed, and so he had to have part of his lung removed. Now he's on the mend. He posted this really emotional video of himself getting dressed, and you can tell he's in pain, but he's getting his clothes on, and he's going to continue to recuperate at home. Luckily, he is going to be okay, but it's a long road to recovery.
Wow.
I'm Jill Dwan with Headlines.
Did that lady ever get the money? I know that's a weird turn right there. I mean, no disrespect, but I mean, that was such a big part of the story, Lady Gaga offering $500,000 for the return of her dogs.
I don't know if she received the money or not. I know that the suspects are still
out.
No one has been arrested or anything yet. So I don't know if she's received that money.
Wow. Okay. I was curious about that. All right. 6:52. It is 104.3 MyFM. It's Valentine in the morning. $11,500 coming up. 7:25. The Battle of the Sexes on the way. If you ever want to play in that, you simply call us up. 866-544-MYFM.
Party girls, don't get hurt.
Play 104.3 MyFM with iHeartRadio.